Amen. Romans chapter 8. There's a very encouraging word in the book of Romans chapter 8 for us this morning on this fifth Sunday morning. I believe the Lord specifically have this word for somebody, if not all of us, today. You have found it, would you kindly say amen? I just want to take and read one verse from Romans 8 and 28. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. You guys probably have heard it and recited it and quoted it. If you're there, let's read. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Let me tag this, if I may, with just three little words. It's all good. Come on and tell the person standing next to you, it's all good. Amen. I don't know what you're going through, what you've been through, what you're still going through, what you may have never came out of, but I come to tell you this morning, it's all good. Not because Kaya said it, but the Lord said it. The Word of God said it. It's all good. I just want to get you in a good place this morning, because some of you may be struggling with something, or you may be angry or bitter about something, because you may feel like God have not come through like he promised, or God haven't fixed what he said he would fix, or God haven't healed when you thought he should heal, or God didn't deliver when you thought he should deliver. But one thing I come to tell you this morning, it's all good. It's all good. It's all good. Romans 8:28 prepares us for storms. Romans 8:28 prepares us for when things are not going great in our life. And if you live, I say this many times, if you live long enough, there's going to be some time in your life things are not going to be going too great. Things are not going to feel too good. Things are not going to look as great. But according to Romans 8:28, it's all good. My brothers and my sisters, there are times when some verses in God's word to the believers does not make good sense. Can I just be honest with us? For example, in one scripture alone, it gives us four things to do that appear to not make good sense. And I'm not a fool by preaching the gospel. I know that some things that we as pastors say, according to his word, it just don't make sense. It's hard to tell somebody that struggling is all good. It's hard to tell somebody who is homeless, it's all good. It's hard to tell somebody who has a broken heart, it's all good. It's hard to tell somebody who has to prepare to bury a loved one, it's all good. But the Bible said, for we know that all things work together for the good of those who loves. Oh, I wish I had a praying church with me this morning. Watch this. You got to love God to be able to say it's all. Deep Brother Cables, you got to have a love on the inside for God that when you're facing something bad, you can just say it's all. Because you know it's in the Master's hand. It may not look good, but when you get done with it, it's all. It's all good. to pray for people who despitefully use you. That don't take a rocket scientist to say, God, that don't make sense for me to pray for somebody who despitefully use me. But if I do what he tells me to do, it's my own. Because if I keep on reading, he said, don't worry about those who use, because eventually I make your enemy. I turn around and make them your footstool. That's why I'm telling you, it's all.
No, 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 no.
can have a
Sunday.
God, children should be able to say, God allowed him to walk out. Because he had other plans for you. You was trying to hold on to someone who was holding you back. It wasn't until he walked out on you that God made it good for you. Oh, baby, it's all. Don't get mad. She don't love me like I love her. She don't treat me like I treat her. God is trying to do something in you. So he allowed a lie sometimes. Crooked, mean people for you to have encounters with. Watch this. And it ended up making you better. It took a crooked person to make you better. I know it's going to hurt some of you. Some people don't like the truth. Some of you are good because of the crooked person you was with. And they out-crook you because you was crooked. But now you good. And it worked out for you good. Oh, baby, in the neighborhood, it's all. Let me tell you. I think we shouldn't get hung up on things that God has already worked in. It took your car to be repossessed. For you to appreciate what God had down the road for you. Watch this. Some of you in church because your car got repossessed. If you had not had your car repossessed, you wouldn't be. Because you thought you was all left in a bag of chips and some pickles to go with. But when God allowed some things to take place, that's when things began to turn around. And that's when you was able to look at the situation and say, it's all. Getting ready to make a cake. by himself is not good. Eating baking soda and flour by itself is not good. Eating a pound of butter by itself, some people may choose to do it. It ain't good. Tablespoon of sugar, a tablespoon of salt just by itself. I didn't like buttermilk, so I didn't drink buttermilk anyway. But when she put it all in a bowl, Brother Cain, and anything that required eggs had to take a beating. And I come to realize that some of us in here don't want to take a thank you. take my